Well, hello guys, it's good to see everyone. Thanks for stopping in to check this video out. And what can I say? Bank of America is still harrying Wizards of the Coast. But before we get into that, I'd like to thank everyone who's subscribed, everyone who's following the channel. We're up to 4,070 plus subscribers now, which is really awesome. So if you haven't already, please consider clicking the subscribe button and the bell icon for notifications. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, please. And remember, this video is brought to you by Hellebard Games. Hellebard publishes the modules they'd like to play, with offerings for OSR, Castles and Crusades, or 5th edition, no matter the adventure. Old school is in play at the table, and you can pick up Hellebard Games from DriveThruRPG or directly from their website at hellebardgames.com. With that said, let's get into it. More bad news for Wizards of the Coast from their old friends at Bank of America. This is from Spiky Bits, and let's jump into it. Bank of America doubles down on a Hasbro D&D and Magic the Gathering crash. They're calling it a crash now. And this is from Rob Baer. I'll link to the article below. Bank of America has doubled down on a potential Hasbro stock crash as consumer confidence continues to drop amid very big concerns for both Magic the Gathering and D&D. It wasn't that long ago when Bank of America did a deep dive into Hasbro and more specifically Magic and didn't like what they found. However, with everything in the report and the consumer outcry to things like the OGL, the anniversary proxies, and release fatigue, we thought Hasbro would listen. Well, according to Bank of America, they haven't made any changes. And I'm just going to stop there for a second, guys. We can speculate all we want about how much impact we had as fans, what influence we had on them. This is Bank of America. They don't care about metal men and funny shaped dice on a table insofar as it does not impact their bottom line. All right, these guys are financial robots, and they will flat out tell the truth. If they're not saying that, if they're saying they're not seeing any changes, guys, that is tectonic. That should worry all of us. But let's continue. So if you haven't heard, in a pre-market report from 2022, Bank of America changed their rating from Hasbro stock from buy to a double downgrade of underperforming. And we talked about that in an earlier video, which a lot of you guys check out, a move that caused ripples in the market. However, things don't seem to be looking up. Bank of America doubles down on Hasbro stock being bad. Well, let's start with the most telling quotes from Bank of America. The company faces a steep decline in its share prices if it continues to destroy customer goodwill. Within its Wizards segment, Hasbro continues to destroy customer goodwill by trying to over-monetize its brands. Do you remember when Williams said that it was under-monetized? Well, any feelings we might have about Bank of America aside, when they look at you and saying you're over-monetizing, brother, you know you've messed up. Not only did BOA say Hasbro is over-monetizing Magic and D&D, but they also moved their projected stock once again. We remain especially cautious on the Hasbro Wizards segment given its over-monetization of Magic. Wizards recently tried a similar tactic with D&D proposing changes to its license agreement, which led to substantial pushback from the community, including calls to boycott the D&D movie. Guys, we made such an impact that Bank of America sat up and took notice. All right? Anybody thinking we didn't? I'll read that again. Wizards recently tried a similar tactic with its D&D proposing changes to its license agreement, which led to substantial pushback from the community, including calls to boycott the D&D movie. All right, we shifted that needle. Anybody out there who's black-pilled is like, and it only matters because we shifted the needle enough that Bank of America took notice. Bank of America. Now, B of A has Hasbro at $42, which is a 29% downgrade. It really feels like BOA has a good grasp on what's happening with the company and how the community continues to push back against the constant issues. As we've said before, it doesn't really feel like Hasbro is trying to expand the player base. They're really just trying to get every last dollar out of the existing player base. And people are starting to get fed up, and there's a little D&D Beyond error page there. In other words, an error has occurred on our side. Please, oh, that's part of the error message, sorry. We've talked a lot about the reserve list, $1,000 proxies, and more, but maybe the most telling thing recently is the community actually prompted Hasbro to stop the OGL licensing. Obviously, this wasn't missed by BOA either. Wizards recently tried a similar... we've already read that. Not only did they boycott, but people stopped their DDB subscriptions, and there was a petition with over 70,000 signatures against the move. Of course, we know about that. While this temporarily stopped the move, you should be cautious as they only did this to stop the bottom from falling out. We don't think this will be the end of it all, and BOA feels the same. However, existing players are starting to get tired of the constant releases, what's happening on the business side, and a weak fan engagement doesn't bode well. We'll have to see if Hasbro listens to Bank of America this time, or if they continue down the same path. Well, that is pretty epic, guys. That is pretty Titanic. So... yeah, Bank of America coming back for a second swing at Hasbro, downgrading them again, warning them that they, Bank of America, have heard us, and warning people in general that Wizards isn't listening. So that is some pretty spicy news there, and I want to know what you guys think of it. Please leave a comment below, and again, if you liked the video, give it a like, and if you haven't subscribed, please click the subscribe button and the bell icon for notifications, and I'll keep an eye on this, because this is pretty big. I mean, you know, this is something that could potentially lead to D&D bouncing into another company's hands, and that might not necessarily be a good thing. So until then, guys, stay positive. We'll be back with more videos later today and tonight, live stream Classic Traveler game as run by our show host, Kyle Schuant. We'll see you then, everybody. Until then, take care. Be good to each other. Peace.